Welcome to Come Knit With Me. Today we are going to work on a purse, which is a child's purse. Now this one is a small version. I am going to actually make a mid-size, about twice this size. Okay, so I want to cast on 50 stitches. I want to make sure I got 50. 'm gonna try with the yellow, hoping I have enough. If not, I'll just put another color into it. It's only a sample, so get your yarn where you're comfortable working from. Get your yarn comfortable from where it's where you're working from. I just do a crochet cast on. Key plate two and a half. You can make this two ways. I do a vertical version. You can also do a horizontal version. And if you want to do the one for the side, you would cast on 100 stitches. And you'd be wanting to put two handles on the top. When I get to the handles, I'll explain that better. Okay, needles. Forward work position. Open, knit the first row with key plate 2.5, so I wanted a fairly snug stitch. First row gets a slow stitching. Now I put my weights on, and the way I like putting my weights on, I bring the needles forward just a little bit, just enough to get the weight to hang on it without splitting the yarn. Then I go into the middle, then I go into the middle, turn the pattern, and I go into the middle. That should be enough. So push my work back. I'm going to knit 5 rows, rib them. That's my next. Okay. Now this one's a little snug to work with. It's only because of the weights are sitting there. Just one. Oops. Change your row counter to zero. Okay, bring forward. I like starting on the third stitch because it gives me room to seam it together. So bring forward every other. And I like making my needles so they don't creep forward on me. So I use a rule yardstick is what it is. I just busted it. Okay, then grab this one, convert. Latch open, flip over. And if the weight gets in your way, just take it off. You can put it back on when you pass that area. You can put it on as you pass that area. Okay. Oops. I forgot to open the latch. I did a scarf using the same key plate, but instead of a number 4 weight yarn, I used a number 3 weight. It would be baby to sport yarn. As I was saying, baby sport yarn. For some reason, it's hesitating on me. Just move the weight over to where the other one was. Reach in, pull. You might have to get creative as to how you hold the weight and the yarn. When you're using the heavier yarn, it is on it. Easy, you put the tool in, push on both sides of the stitch you want it to open up and drop to ladders. See if I can get close. There. We'll talk about how I, the method to my madness, about the handle, because that's what we're doing right now. Remember, we got 50 stitches. I'm almost jumping ahead of myself. Okay, got 50 stitches. So what we'll do, let me show you on this little one. We're gonna fold it in a half in our head, which is so we can find the center. Then we're gonna fold that in half and find the center. And we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So it's basically one third of the rows across. So 50 doesn't divide too hot. So we're gonna want 25 would be the center. Half of that is 12 and a half. So I want to go 13. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, there's 13. I'm going to go ahead and place a marker. And then we're going to go 13 from the outside. That's a bit much for a handle. So let's go half that again and move the handle in. Okay, and half that again and move the marker back. Yeah, that's a little better. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, rib. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. Yeah. All right. Carriage is on my right, as you just saw it. So I am going to put the needles that are left of the carriage and left of the marker closest to the carriage, and you're gonna push them in non-work position. Go ahead and knit the row. And put these in forward hold position. Leave these in the forward hold. Push the others center. You can either leave them or put them in the center. And now we are going to do a crochet cast off. There we go. I have to take my glasses off. Now, one of the ways I do the crochet cast tops, I lay the yarn across the stitches, bring the yarn down under, and I hold that with my sort of free hand, the one that's not holding the tool. Okay. Sorry, I forgot about all the dips and stops. trying a new program, and I think it's too big for my laptop. Okay. If you don't want to hold it, you can kind of clip it to the work. I'm just doing it loose. I can tighten it up if I wanted. It's your choice. Do not split the yarn. If you do, just undo it. Oops. Get carried away with undoing it. Okay. Yeah, don't split it. Okay. Now this loop, we go ahead and put on the first needle. Okay. Now, push your work back. You can either leave them now on the machine or go ahead and take them off. Because I like to go ahead and take them off. We'll be finishing this row. Leave these in forward hold. Unthread your carriage. Bring your carriage, making sure these stayed in the forward work position. Forward hold position. Okay, load the carriage up. And finish knitting. But in order to knit, you need them into forward work position with the latches open. Okay. Now you need the others that were in forward hold put into the forward work. And the ones that you put in the hold, you need to bring forward so when you get brain change, put these in forward hold. You gotta stitch these, cast on these, then stitch those. So it's a three-part. So it's one, move, bring the carriage back. Now this one, you can push these into forward work, unthread the carriage, move it temporarily out of your way, bring enough leeway yarn. You're going to either E-wrap or do a crochet cast on. E-wrap would be this. Okay, that would be an E-wrap, and if you have the claw weights, just hang them right on to them. Now if you want to crochet, cast on. Okay, yeah, you got to pick up a loop. And then just crochet it across. and hang the loop on the next stitch. Put all of them, leave these in forward, hold these into forward work, thread your carriage, and knit the rest of the row. My needle's not lined up right. Okay. Now, these go into forward work. Latches open. And knit 5 rows. Okay. Now, counter is on 7, and it should be on 6, because you did 5, then the row that created the handle. So now we have 5 more rows. I do this center slow. Remember, you don't have any weights. Now go ahead and hang weights on the handle. Excuse me. There. I wanted to stitch. Okay, so it's 1, 2. Now we want to do the ribbing. You want to make sure that you use the same needles as your previous set of ribbing. Now, if you don't want to do a rib, you could do any non-curl type thing, you know, seed stitch. Okay. There we go. Much better. Oh yeah. Go ahead and open up your latches. Make sure they... Okay, those aren't the ones you gotta worry, you wanna open. These are the ones. Okay. Alright, so those latches are open. Sounds weird. actually, opening up those latches didn't do what my mind thought it was going to do. So don't worry about that part. And if the weight gets in the way, just move it and put it back on afterwards. Just like before, if the weight is in the way, just temporarily move it. In this case, if you want it, you could hang it reverse. Let's see if that'll work. Work quite nicely. Just remember, those things can hurt if you land on them. Okay, let's turn these around. I don't want to scrape my hand on them. Want to take down crud. We can fix it. I'm gonna need temporarily a stitch holder. And what I'll do is I'll just take a couple stitches and attach it to the side. When I get this done, I'll be knitting about 20 rows, no, 20, about 30 rows. Well, actually 60 rows, because I was thinking double the amount. Because one side's the front. One side's the back. Now if you want to put like a intarsia on this, remember one side is upside down and one side is right side up, but they're both backwards. Thank you. I get annoyed with myself. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and place the marker here because that is the edge and the beginning of my knitting. Fix your drops right away. Okay. I forgot what I was doing. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. So I'm going to change this to 7. Then I don't have to mend any time. Stripe it if you want. Okay, I got a latch. So what I'm doing, I'm putting a straight edge down the length so that I can flip the latch back. Okay, I have to re-knit the last stitch. I'm going to move my weights up. I think the next one I do, I'm going to try doing seam as I go on the sides. I'm going to how much we have. I'm just gonna knit, oop. Not much anyway. Sometimes you take the work and wiggle it like that, and it'll put the needles into the right spot. I'm not sure if I have enough to make it completely. So I'm gonna go upstairs and knit the top of my skein. And then I'll take out the amount of rows I need. This is a bodkin. It's got a opening at both ends. It's also good for, I've actually used it sewing up some work. Take off the split. Oh, good. I have enough. So, what I actually have to do is hold on. Be right back. Hold it. All right, we're back. Now, to see how big it is, just bring it up, and I think I found a little bit more, so I'm gonna go until I run out of this, and then I'll see if it's the length I want it to be. Okay, got 73 rows. Let me write that down. Okay, now I'm going to attach this yarn to this. And the way I do it, I make a single knot up at this end. And then I take that end and make a single knot at this end. And then I pull it tight. Then I cut this off fairly close. Then I continue knitting. Five. Now I'm going to, I always forget which one I did. Okay, so third one in. These I'm going to convert to rib. There we go. Thank you for bearing with me. Okay, so now I want to be careful with the first one. So I go 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Once I have this one in, I'll be able to ladder it back up. Being stubborn. Okay, find where I did it and move over. Okay, ladder. Don't worry about that stitch that's coming off. It's not going to go far until I pull it. There we go. Now we're going to be doing the handle. Do the handle in the same manner that we're doing that we did the previous handle. Now, if you want to make this bag longer, do it before you do the band. Just do like I showed you and pull it up and see if that's how size you want. Now, sometimes it's easier to unladder more than one at a time. So what I do is I'll take a straight tool or a stitch holder and just catch the stitch. Staying in the same row. And now I'm looking up and across. Okay. And then just release. Not that one. Then just pull down. Or push it in. You could push it in. That'll release it easily. Now just grab the loop or stitch and ladder up. Just remember to make the loop the same size as the stitch. Oops. a little space behind the tool. Double pointed needle, stitch holder, marker, whatever you want to call it. Bring it in a little bit. There. Okay. So we want to stick in there. Just following the row over. If you get lost, just count down 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And you pick up the next stitch. I think I just split it there. There we go. There we go. There we go. Pull these off. Pull or push. Okay. Pick up the loop. And I have not edited anything out. And I don't plan on it. I did have some interference earlier when the door opened up, but I don't think it's going to be a problem. Because if you were here knitting with me, you'd have to you hear it too. I don't release the stitch until I've laddered it up and rehung it. There we go. And release it. Because you never know. Okay. Whoops. Get annoyed with myself. Now I know what happened. When I tried to flip it, the latch was on here, on the, I don't know what you call those. It's the bed of the machine. It's the part I usually get scrapes from. You can adapt this pattern to whatever size you need. I made a small one, which I don't have anymore. And I only did, what was it? 25 stitches, that's right. Because this one's 50. And I think the next size up, I would go to 75. And the first one, I knitted 15 rows. With this one, I needed 30, but I ended up going with 35. To sew the sides together, I'm just going to use the Bickerford seam. Try to put this where you can see it. Make sure you don't split it, especially on purpose like that. You may have to use your other hand to see the ladder. Excuse me. Okay. Last one. Now, because I pulled those stitches out a little bit, I'm going to kind of set it by giving it a tug. Anyway. See, that puts it right back. Okay, bring my weights up. Now, my pad, I'm going to put my notes. Gave me, let's see, the small one. Okay. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 ribs. I gotta go from this side. So I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 ribs. Okay, so that's where I start. I want to make sure we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so this has to be 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So these go in forward hold position, knit these 8, excuse my arm, okay, now put these in forward hold, slide carriage back over to the right. Now these center ones you're going to cast off. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And I'm using the weight as a marker. Okay. Releasing the yarn from the carriage. Pulling the work out a little bit. Get my hand where I can work it. Okay, and just start crochet cast off. Until I reach my marker. Let me move. There. Okay. I'm kind of releasing my hand in the back so I get a smooth loop. That's a little too smooth. Okay. And this loop goes on here. Excuse me. Now, first eight are in forward hold position. Now, is that one of them? Okay, so it's one. Aha! Look familiar? I'm going to make sure I grab that one. Okay, put those back. These forward. These in forward work position with latches open. I'm not going to bother move the cap. Okay. Make sure I have plenty of yarn. Bring my carriage over. Sitting over and hold, go back into work position with latches open. Okay, they don't. They go forward. I knit these first. Then these come forward. Up, cast on these, and it's a e-wrap. Showing you another way it can be done. Okay, these are forward work position. Forward hold. Now, what I'm going to do, remember that stitch? I'm going to go grab it and loop it and put it right there. Okay. Latches all open. Thread my machine. Back up a little bit here. Whoop. Way. There. Okay. Now put these back into work position. Double check the latches. Knit the row. When I get here, I'm going to go kind of slow when I get to that portion of it. See if I can get this. Okay. before I go too far, I'm gonna go ahead and put my weights on. Dropped a stitch over here. I found it and just re-hang it. Okay. So now I want 5 more rows. Forget it. I have a habit of that. And this thing I'm holding, it's made out of polymer clay and craft sticks, the large ones. So there we go. Push my needles back. Just convert these to rib. Oh, 1 minute. since I've had this issue earlier. Everything is all said and done. If you don't like the edging, just do a row a single crochet around it. Myself, I don't have a problem with it. So far, I've done everything on camera. Make sure I don't drop a stitch here. Nope, good. Now you can do the whip stitch to put this together. Just a regular stitch. You could do a mattress stitch if you wanted to. Personally, don't want the bulky seam there. Excuse me. That was my carriage. Get a rhythm set up sooner or later. Just be patient with yourself. Now again, this is Red Heart yarn. I think it's weight 4. I don't know what that was. I may have dropped a weight. Okay. Now, bring your work forward and a little bit back. Oh. I'd lose my head if it wasn't attached. Now I showed you holding it like this. Okay, now I'm going to show you another way. You know, when you're crocheting, hold it kind of like that. Can you see that? Not really. Okay. My elbow's getting in the way. But I'm holding it like this and using my finger to manipulate the working yarn, holding it up where I can grab it. I'll be able to show you better when I get to the other end. So I just push it in and down. Now, if you're having trouble finding the hole, turn your latch tool around and just hook it. And then rotate your work and you'll have the hole. Oh! I just noticed some of my stitches are not on the machine. So I'm going to take some time. Put them back on the machine. Now another way you can do this is throw this on waste yarn and take it off the machine and then crochet across. There we go. Now where was I? Oops. Make sure you get every stitch. Another way you can do is just hold it. So I'm using my thumb, oops, to put the yarn in the spot that I need it. Gotta make sure you grab the thread so that it'll put all through. Thank you. Kitty Coin. There we go. Sorry. If you really have issue getting it, push it back, past the latch, and pull it off onto the tool. But don't drop it. But if you drop it, just kind of come in, kind of from the back, restitch it, and then cast it off. Yarn's on the top. Okay. Now you want to leave at least enough yarn to sew it together. And had I thought about it when I did it, I cast it, it would still be on the wrong end. Okay. There's the bag. Sorry about that. There's the bag. So I'll turn it inside out. And with my long hand, I will just seam this down. Okay. I'll be back at that to show you the finished product. And we're at the last step of our little purse. I've got it turned inside out. You will need a yarn needle. Take that long thread that you left, and thread your needle. Now you don't want a real long, leave it long. So leave it just so that you have a little bit to work with. And I'm just going to do an over, like a slip stitch type stitch, picking up a stitch at the top. And all I'm going to do is pick up one from one side and pick up one from the other. Now you can hold your thread down a minute. There. All right. Let's go in one side. I'm going to take the knot of one side with the loop of the other. There. And the tail, the other tail rather, you can just wrap the stitch. Just wrap. Sorry about that. Just wrap the stitch in between the tail, whatever you want to call it. Just make sure it's inside the over and under. Now if that stitch holder gets in your way, just take it off. You can do the Kirchner if you want to, but I'm choosing not. I'm going to call this the medium. If you want to make it bigger, just double it. You know, do side of which I'm 25 was the smallest. This one is 50. So if you add 25 stitches to that, the next size up would be 75 cast on. And the first set of rows is 30. The second, I did 35, I think. And the third would be about 45 rows. Very forgiving pattern. You can customize it. Now, I'm not going to film doing the other side, because it's just the same as this, and I don't want to bore you. Excuse me. When you get to the end, you're going to go all the way to the end. Then I turn the work. I check, make sure everything's got stitched up. Don't forget, we got that one over here. There we go, over here, to still fix itself. And just weave your end in. And snip it off. Oops, I'm going to go ahead and take care of that lone stitch. Gonna go down through. I'm gonna do a little tie. And weave this thread in. I can take the hook off now. Hiding the other thread as I hide the long one. Then I can cut them both off together. Right side out. And now, like I said, I'll do the other half off camera. And there's your purse. It's a nice little, for a little girl. Okay, I'll catch you next time when I decide. I don't know what I'm gonna make yet. It'll be interesting. Bye for now.